Hello everyone, DonellHD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up the Wiimote for PS1 light gun games with Duckstation on LaunchBox. The requirements for this tutorial are one Mayflash Dolphin Bar and one Wiimote. Now I'm not going to go through the whole process of telling you how to install the Wii Bar because it's pretty self-explanatory and it's plug and play. But once you have plugged it in, press the sync button on the Dolphin Bar and press the sync button on the Wiimote. Both items will blink. But once the Wiimote turns to a solid color, you're good to go. The bar will blink for a little bit longer and then eventually turn solid as well. Now we can continue with the rest of the tutorial. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here. And inside that folder, I have my LaunchBox folder, my emulators folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left the link in the description below for everything you're going to need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download. I also left a link to the Visual Studio 2022 redistributable, as it is required to run Duckstation unless you have Duckstation working already from a previous install. Okay, I've downloaded the Duckstation light gun file and placed it here on my desktop. What I'm going to do now is extract the contents of it into my emulators folder. Okay, I'm going to open up the emulator for the first time. I'm going to go in emulators, Duckstation light gun, and the Duckstation QTEXE here. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is go to settings, controllers. Okay, to the left here, we're going to go to controller, port 1, gun con. The emulator is already pre-configured for the Wiimote and mouse, so all you have to do is go here to settings, and in the crosshair image path, I left the crosshair in the Duckstation emulators folder if you require it, or you can use your own. You do require a PNG though, so go here to the crosshairs folder here, and here's your crosshair here. Now you can click close. Now I'm going to go to settings, graphics. At the top in the renderer section, if you're using a graphics card, select Vulkan. And under adapter, select your graphics card. I set it at 1080p, but you can adjust this section here to your needs. Once you're done, click close. And then close the emulator. Now we're gonna set the emulator up in LaunchBox. Okay, now that we're here in LaunchBox, we're gonna go to the top left corner here. We're gonna go to Tools, Manage, Emulators. We're going to click add. The name of our emulator, we're going to name it Duckstation light gun. Just don't name it Duckstation by itself. Now we're going to set the path. My path is located on the desktop, arcade, emulators, Duckstation light gun, and the Duckstation EXE here. Now we're going to go to associated platforms, and we're going to make sure that we name our platform Sony PlayStation. And do not check the box to set it as the default emulator. Now I'm going to go to the running script area, and I left the script in the description below that if you require it, you can escape out of the emulator by pressing the escape key. I'm going to paste that here, and then I'm going to click OK, and then close. Now it's time to import our ROMs. I'm using the drag and drop method today, so I'm going to go down here to my ROMs folder, and I'm going to grab my four games, and I'm going to drop them into LaunchBox like so. What type of game files are you importing? Select ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Make sure you select Sony PlayStation. Next, manually configure emulator. What emulator would you like to use? Make sure you select Duckstation light gun. Next, if you get a missing dependency files pop up, simply go up here to browse and select your folder where your emulator is, and select the system folder here. Click select folder when you're done. When you see the green light here, you're good to go. Click next. Use files in their current location. Next, 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 next. Make sure your games are spelled correctly, and then click finish. Okay, now that we've installed our games, let's test them out. At the gun calibration screen, use your Wiimote or mouse to move to the center of the screen and pull the trigger. Once you've done that, press left or right on the Wiimote or left or right on the keyboard. If your Wiimote is synced in mode 2, simply press any button on your Wiimote, and when you see the lights 1 and 4, you're good to go. and I have no issues with time crisis. Or Time Crisis Project Titan. Point blank 3 shoots just fine. And I found I can only use the Japanese version of Resident Evil Survivor, and that the gun calibration screen, left and right, have to be pressed at the same time to finish the calibration, so you probably have to use your keyboard. Controls for this game are very different. Use left and right on your Wiimote to turn, and A on your Wiimote to walk. And then when it comes time to shoot zombies, you can shoot. And now we've come to the end of our video. Thank you so much for watching. If this video helped you out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I'm creating more of these Wiimote tutorials in the future, so stay tuned to the channel. Once again, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.